guys about one of my favorite things, the elderly. So I got involved with the elderly care ministry in kind of a non-traditional way, probably. About a year and a half ago, I was really looking for something that, a way to volunteer, a way to serve. And so I got on Newman's website and started looking at different programs that they have. And there was one that really stuck out to me, and that was elderly care. I hadn't worked with the elderly at all before. It was kind of a new thing. I hadn't volunteered, I hadn't visited really any relatives in a nursing home before. But for some reason, it kind of stuck out. I didn't have time that semester to really get involved, but then last spring semester, I took the first step and went to Candlelight Nursing Home. But before I go into much more of my talk, I kind of want you guys to close your eyes first. And I want you to think about a time when you truly felt God. Imagine yourself in that moment. Where are you? Are there people surrounding you? What does it smell like? What kinds of things do you hear around you? Can you feel them surrounding you? The warmth radiating onto your skin. You get tingly all over your body. You feel relaxed and at peace. You can open your eyes. I want you to keep this feeling in mind as I go through my talk today. I'm going to share some stories about the people that I've met, the people whose lives I've gotten to experience. So last spring semester, I started going to Candlelight every week, and I got to sit with the residents and listen to the stories that they had to share. They would tell us stories about their lives, where they grew up, things that they loved to do, their families, their sons and daughters. And it was so great. We would sit and laugh and have a lot of fun. And then we would go back to the next week and we would have similar conversations. Usually they didn't remember us being there the week before. And so they shared a lot of the same stories. And we'd have the same laughs. And during this semester, I was really contemplating what God had planned for me. I had a plan to go into an agricultural field and work in business. And this semester, I really felt that this career plan wasn't going to really be fulfilling to me. So as I worked with the elderly at Candlelight, I really got a new sense of fulfillment. Every time I went there and talked to the residents, I felt at peace and happy. And this kind of molded a new career path for me. At the end of that semester, I rescinded an offer to intern at an ag company to go back home. Not exactly ideal for after my junior year of college. But I went back home and I worked at an assisted living center for Alzheimer's and dementia residents. And it was a lot different of an experience for me. Whenever I went to Candlelight, we would spend an hour there a week. We got to see a lot of the happy things, the good times. But whenever you work in a nursing home facility, you spend 8 to 10 to 12 hours with people. And you see the good, the bad, and the ugly. This was a place that I still really felt God's calling while I was there. So there was one specific instance when I really could feel God. I had this resident. She was a lady that went to my church. I had known that she grew up going to the Catholic Church with my family. And so I was trying to start a conversation with her. And I said, "Hey, you go to the Catholic Church, right?" And she looked at me and she laughed. And she said, "No, I'm Presbyterian." And I laughed because I really didn't know what to say, and I just kind of moved the conversation along to something else. That following Sunday, I was working at a 12-hour shift, and the Eucharistic minister from the Catholic Church came and sat with us, and she said, "Hey, Abrea, come over here." And I sat with the same resident that had earlier told me she was Presbyterian, and we prayed the Hail Mary, and then we prayed the Our Father, and then we received Holy Communion. And it was just so funny to me because we had just had this conversation, and it really made me realize just how deeply rooted our faith is. This resident is a resident, she has a lot of spunk. She's very lively and always pretty happy, but she doesn't remember much. She usually doesn't remember where she's at or how she got there, or if you tell her something, she doesn't remember it for much longer than 2 minutes. But she could remember the Hail Mary, and she could remember the Our Father. And she remembered just how important it was. And in that moment, I really felt God surrounding me and surrounding us. That same tingly feeling, that same warmth. I had another resident at the facility I worked at over the summer. And she was very lively. I got to learn a lot about her. Her husband would come every day and sit with her for a few hours in the afternoon. And he would tell us a lot of stories about her, what she was like growing up. She was a very proper woman. She always volunteered at church and was very religious, and she always did the right things. And it was funny because her personality was changed a lot whenever she got Alzheimer's. But nonetheless, she has been a joy, and she always has a lot of really great comments to me sometimes. She's very spunky. But one thing I learned about her was that she had played the piano her whole life, and she was very well known for being just this really great piano player. And while she was at the facility, she had really become very weak, very frail. She couldn't use her hands very much, couldn't stand or walk on her own. But my boss had told me that she would sometimes play piano, but it had been a long time. So one day when she was feeling good, I said, let's see if we can play some piano today, and kind of pushed her and walked her over to the piano bench and sat her down, and she complained and didn't want to play at all. She said, "I don't remember how. I don't know what you're talking about. I don't play piano." But I sat her down on the bench anyway and kind of propped her up. And she said, "I need a hymn book if I'm going to play piano." So we found a book and we propped it up on the piano. And she placed her hands on the keys and started to play. And she played Amazing Grace and Jesus Loves Me. And it was just so cool because she's a woman that doesn't remember a lot of things even when her husband comes to visit her. She hallucinates things about 95% of the time, but she could remember how to play Amazing Grace without being able to read the hymn book. And you could see that really, that Jesus really does love her, and especially shine through in those moments. When I came back last fall to school, it was really hard to leave all of my residents at home. And just knowing the kind of desperation and loneliness that they felt. But it gave me a lot different perspective on the volunteering at Candlelight and the things that we can do for the elderly. When I came back last fall, I started back at Candlelight, and a lot of the residents that had been there in the spring had been moved to different facilities, or they had been moved into the Alzheimer's unit, and there were a lot of new people there too. So I went back to the Alzheimer's unit and just asked if there was anything that I could do. And one of the ladies that works there, Carol, she was there every week, she said, yeah, you can take this tray of food and this orange juice and go give Eddie dinner. And I said, okay. Thought it would be a pretty simple task. So I took the food into Eddie's room, and I saw him sitting there. And he was in his wheelchair, sitting with his sweatshirt pulled up over his head completely. And he was just moaning and yelling. And I said, hi, Eddie. This is Abrea. I'm here. I have some dinner for you. Can you pull your sweatshirt down? And he eventually, reluctantly, pulled the sweatshirt down, and I was able to kind of get a little bit more read on Eddie and who he was. So I sat the TV tray up in front of him and sat dinner there, expecting him to reach for the food or eat eventually. But he didn't really move, and so I put the spoon in the food and kind of handed him some chips, hoping that this would like encourage him to start eating. And as it went along, I started to realize that Eddie wouldn't look me in the eyes or really didn't have a sense of where I was at in relation to him. And I tried to hand him some orange juice, and he didn't reach for it. I said, Eddie, can you see this orange juice I'm trying to hand you? And he said, no. And I said, Eddie, can you see me? And he said, no. Of course, this was scrambled up sentences of words, and eventually I realized that Eddie couldn't see at all. And so I had to take a little bit of a step back and a little bit different approach. Eddie, as I helped him eat his dinner, sat there and cried out for a long time. He was scared. He didn't know who I was. He didn't know what was happening. He couldn't see anything that was going on around him. He probably didn't know where he was at or what was going to happen. So as he ate, I held his arm and he grabbed my hand. He counted each one of my fingers individually and squeezed my hand for a long time. Thinking about it, it just brings me to tears, but I could see God's face in him. That feeling of God that surrounds you, that tingliness, that same sensation that I had you think about at the beginning, is what I feel whenever I visit the elderly, whenever I visit Eddie and him, my residents at home. Working with the elderly is not glamorous. It is often heartbreaking, frustrating, and completely exhausting. The work done with the elderly is difficult because there really are not a lot of solutions. The illnesses they have are likely not going to go away. Their Alzheimer's is probably not going to be cured. Their weakness cannot be rebuilt. Their sight's not going to be regained. And it's likely that their health is not going to get better. And this is why they become forgotten. However, their lives are no less important. They still have so much life left to live. Many people don't view the elderly as people who contribute to society or have any kind of life left in them, but this is completely false. They're forgotten because they have become too difficult to take care of or too much of How can we deny them? St. Mother Teresa said, "The greatest disease in the West today is not TB or leprosy. It is being unwanted, unloved, and uncared for. We can cure physical diseases with medicine, but the only cure for loneliness, despair, and hopelessness is love. There are many in the world who are dying for a piece of bread, but there are many more dying for a little love. The poverty in the West is a different kind of poverty. It is not only a poverty of loneliness, but also a spirituality. There's a hunger for love, as there is a hunger for God." As I prepared for today, I thought about a lot of the stories of the elderly that I work with, and I shared with you just a few. There certainly are many more that I would love to share with anyone who would like to talk about them. And there are a lot of happy times and a lot of sad times that come to mind. It's not an easy thing to do by any means, and it's one that can be really hard to talk about too. I kind of want to end by giving a little bit of insight into what we can do for the elderly. Prayer is probably the biggest thing. Just praying for them, praying for their loneliness and that they can be at peace. They feel so much sadness and loneliness individually, and just prayer that God can be with them is huge. Also, I'll give a shameless plug for the elderly ministry. It's called Never Alone Ministry to the Elderly, broken down to name. I like to call it Old and Bold because that's more fun. But we go a few times a week. Right now we're kind of trying to figure out the schedule. We're going on Wednesdays at 4:30 for sure. We spend about an hour with them while we're there. Just being able to spend some time with them gives them some happiness, and that's the biggest thing that I think we can do to be able to serve. There are a lot of residents at Candlelight, and there are a lot of nursing homes in Columbia as well. I think there's probably 6 to 10 different nursing homes, and we visit one or two. And so there's a lot of work to be done, a lot of loneliness and lonely people that we can bring God's love to. So if you feel called, or if you just want to check the program out or see what it's about, want to serve, I encourage you to come with us to Candlelight Lodge. I can introduce you to some of the elderly that are there. They just love to see a friendly face, somebody that's going to talk to them individually. It's really hard in this industry to be able to do the job as well as give each of them individualized conversation and care. And so those volunteers